first item, third item, is to reconvene, and fourth item is consideration adoption of minutes. Last regular meeting, also the executive meeting, June 19th, 2012, executed the same day. I assume the council got a copy of the minutes of that, those days, if no correction. Chair will entertain a motion. Motion to have a second. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous, thank you very much. Okay, item five, proclamation, resolutions, regulations, there being none. Item six, old business, there being no old business. Item seven, new business. Item eight, planning zoning. Number one is Sunny EMC annexation request, 042012.
Yes, sir. We'll
you might want to bring what that request is.
Yes, sir. If you'll address us on this report, in fact, so I'll do that. The planning board held a public hearing for this proposed annexation on June 19th, and they went over the board public comments and they voted unanimously to forward the request of the city council with recommendation approval to annex and rezone the properties to highway business. The assigned EMC has filed a petition to annex 5-60% method of the following 13 parcels, total of 40.41 acres. It's tax map C-19, parcel 015, C-19-016, C-19-017, C-19-018, C-19-019, C-19-020, C-19-021, C-19-022, C-19-023, C-19-024, C-19-026, C-19-027, C-19-029. These parcels are directly adjacent to the existing city boundary and therefore they're compliant with state annexation law. And Forsyth County has responded in writing that they have no objection to proposed annexation. You have a copy of the attorney's letter in the back. To the best of our knowledge, the proposed annexation of rezoning a highway business will not be detrimental to the owner's value use of adjoining their properties, and the proposed highway business zoning is in conformance with the city's future land use plan for this area. I'll be happy to answer any questions you have.
And these are annexation requests by Sony EMC, and even though they join the city, basically the city surrounds most of them.
Yes, sir.
So this is, we already served some EMC with utilities anyway.
That's right.
Council, have any questions? Thank you, Scott. I hear a motion to open for public hearing. Is that a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Anyone here like to speak in favor of the annexation request? Sony EMC 042012. Anybody here like to speak in opposition? There's an annexation request, Sony EMC 042012. If not, I hear a motion public hearing be closed. Have a second?
Second.
Unanimous. Thank you very much.
I think I'll ask you for a vote. Again, all in favor of closing the public hearing. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Does that require a vote tonight?
Yes, sir, because I ask that you will vote to approve the annexation as well as the rezoning of the properties of highway business.
Okay. I hear a motion that annexation of Sony EMC 042012 be approved as presented. Motion from Rupert, second. Russ, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. I hear a motion that this is properly brought into the zoning as requested. Our motion for Rupert, have a second. Is in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand, we have, thank you very much, Scott.
Thank you.
Item B, Recreation Department. All in the brochure bids?
Yes, sir. It's, we're trying to wrap up our summer season. The Recreation Department being ready for our fall event programming. We have solicited and received bids for the painting of our fall event programming brochure. Bids were taken for 21,000 copies of a 16-page brochure. We received three bids back. Three bids received for Gravitt edge for $3,600. Soil graphics from Honea for $6,210. And Rico USA Atlanta for $7,816.46. Our recommendation is that we do go with the low bid from Gravitt edge for $3,600. They have worked with us for the past 3 or 4 years in cleaning our brochure. Always did an outstanding job at everything to us in the top of that.
Your board recommend Gravitt edge, which is low bid by about $3,300.
Yes, sir.
And they also get upcoming.
Yes, and they're a local business.
Let's pass the board on the request of purchasing following brochure bids for the park rent.
I make a motion to Gravitt edge.
Have a motion from Willis that the following brochure bids be filed for Gravitt edge, have a second. Second Quincy, in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand, we have, thank you very much. Great, also, Park and Rec, item two, balance beam purchase.
That's correct. Our balance beam that is used for our gymnastics program at the Oxford Recreation Center is over 15 years old. It used to be an adjustable beam that could be raised and lowered depending on the level and age of the children using it. It has lost that capacity. So we have solicited bids for a beam to replace that for the gymnastics program. The three bids we received were Win-Win Athletic from Lawrenceville for $3,262.50. EGS 9.9 Sports from Connecticut for $3,300. And B&G Sports from California for $3,600. It is our recommendation that we use the bid from Win-Win Athletic of Lawrenceville. $3,262.50. We have utilized Win-Win in the past with some of the outfitting for the gymnastics program, and they've done a good job of having items to us in a timely manner, but if there's ever any problem with it, then dealing with them and being able to quickly to do something.
Win-Win Athletic Lawrenceville, and that's the closest bid we had to the area, right?
So,
and the other one was out of state, the other bid was out of state.
Yeah, the other two were out of state. So.
And this was, I think this was placed at the gymnastics place.
Yes, sir.
What's placed before? Everybody. Have a motion from Rupert, have a second. Second from John D., in discussion. All in favor of purchasing the beams for the Park and Rec Gymnastic Department for $3,262.50 for Win-Win Athletic at Lawrenceville, signify by raising your right hand. You know, thank you very much. Also, under Recreation, we have computer purchases. It's my understanding that these are updated. This is being done by the IT department, their own IT department. This is just to purchase the equipment to go ahead and redo that by our own personnel.
That's correct. Chad Faulkner has recommended this is part of the process over the next 3 years of phasing out our older computers in the recreation department and replacing them with updated models. Our request is to purchase and replace three of the computers at the recreation department this year. The three desktop models at a cost of $1,069.45 each, for a total of $3,208.35.
Okay, this is the request is Greg alluded to for SCD International and Arnsville also. $1,069.45 for a total of $3,208.35. Motion by the board. Motion Quincy, have a second.
Second.
Dundee, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. You have it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, I received the police department. I have one alcohol request for Reeves, Patty, and Debbie. They did the market, Chief Taylor.
Good evening, Mayor.
Good morning,
Council. We received an application for Reeves, Patty, and Debbie, Incorporated. Daily bakery market request for license for the sale of wine and all beverages that are drunk from Sergeant Martins. I did conduct a background check and nothing was disclosed to preclude the issuance of alcohol license. All appropriate fees have been paid and the licensee is in compliance with the city of Blackburn. The licensee is Ms. Karen Marie Smith, and I would recommend that you approve this application.
Our investigation showed no issues or problems with the applicant, and all the fees have been paid. What's the pleasure for them? Item 1, alcohol license request for Reese, Daddy, and Debbie.
Make a
motion. Make a motion. Please. Have a
second.
Second, Judge. Quincy, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item 2, alcohol license request by Michael Mann. Keith Taylor.
We also received an application from Cumming Mann LLC doing business in Copperland. They requested a license for the sale of the steel streams, wine, and all beverages by the drink, for consumption on premises. We did the background check and nothing was disclosed to complete issuance of a license. All appropriate fees have been paid and the license is in compliance with the city of Blackburn. Velocity is not changing on this application. What basically happened is the LLC has done some consolidation and the owner has definitely changed. It's still the same owner by name, but the LLC is trying to get rid of the company with involved in the LLC pulled out, and therefore that's a change in ownership of the
people. When that happens, some things like that, I believe. But everything's in order. Passing fees are paid. Okay. The recommendation by Chief Davis, alcohol license request for Copper Man for special rule. Motion. John D. Have a second.
Second.
Second. Willis, any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay. Leaving an agenda ordinance of City Attorney, Payne Miles.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, members of the council. This is the ordinance of the city related to regular meetings. The mayor of council has actually started the agenda to an important ordinance by that day from the other person. The agenda of this ordinance is that combined with other changes that y'all made earlier this year, is to the meeting will start at 6. Unlike your previous or existing ordinance, which has a specified time for executive session. 6 to 7:30, this would really be at the discretion of the mayor and council if the decision is needed, and the length of it would be governed by whatever is needed as opposed to have a preset hour and a half. So we start at 6 and take the decision to do all that's needed and we're including the mayor. So that would be the intent. If you combine the changes to the land here, the changes to John made earlier this year, sets up a standard agenda for y'all to use, and the effective date would be prior to the date of your next meeting. This would be effective, in essence, tomorrow, if you pass the time. So this would go into effect for your next meeting. Glad to answer the questions.
Councilman, any questions? This is something we need to act on?
Yes, sir.
7:30 to 6 o'clock, something that would hopefully accommodate people who want to come to meet rather than getting off work and going home and maybe having dinner and coming back to a meeting. So we're trying to accommodate everybody so that they want to come to the meeting. So, of course, pleasure the board and meet the agenda ordinance. Given by the city attorney.
I have a motion to adopt as presented. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
On item E, GMRC appointment from the private sector. We have been received a letter from Georgia Mountain appointment for the private sector, joint appointment between the city and county. And that appointment previously was James McCoy of the Chamber of Commerce. He has indicated that, according to the letter that we received, that he would continue to serve if appointed. So the recommendation is that we reappoint James McCoy to the Georgia Mountains RDC. I have a motion from Ralph. He's a member representing the city also that serves on the Georgia Mountain Commission. I have a second from John Day. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item F. Some months ago when we started water discussion, the city board, this board authorized a rate study to be done by a civil engineer company. So we have with us tonight, Coach Johnson, the civil engineer, that's going to make a presentation based on the findings that we asked him to do for the rate study of water and sewer. So, Coach, if you would, podium's yours, and if we can get a copy of your study put on the screen in the middle, well, you got it up right there.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. As you said, we've been working on a water rate study to look at the rate that the city would be charged to the county on drinking water, sewer treatment, and water. So tonight I'm going to come to you and show you what we're finding and prepare you for where you've got to go for this time. First thing I'm going to do is talk about the comparative rate study that we did looking at the surrounding communities on water and sewer. And then after I show you that, then we'll break it down into the recommended rates that you can consider for water, sewer, and water. So the first slide we have up there is this comparative rate study. We look at the surrounding community and how 19 different systems relatively close. And what we did is we looked at the water rates, which are shown on the left hand column, and we looked at the sewer rates shown on the right hand column. And doing that, every community's got a little bit different rate structure. Some of them is the first 2,000 gallons, and might be a fixed amount. Others might be a fixed amount for 3,000 gallons. So what we did was to normalize it so that each community which would have a rate for 7,000 gallons a month. And as you can see on the left-hand side looking at the water, was 19 average $5.31 per 1,000 gallons, with the maximum being $11.16 in the minimum, 248. What you might notice is the city of Cumming being $2.48, which is well below the average. The city of Gainesville was $6.10 a thousand, which is higher. Roswell, which is a comfortable community, is $4.76. So I guess the thing, tell you what, the first part of the slide is that you've got 19 communities, you're wide around your waterways. But when you look at city of Cumming, there's only 7,000 gallons used, is less significant.
Let me interrupt you if you would. Now, I'm looking at your 19 surrounding cities that, and you've got one here that's in with all of it. The other that you averaged in there is Beaufort, the city of Beaufort. And it looks like theirs is 255, and it, even the survey is 57 cents a thousand. Can you explain that a little bit, maybe?
I don't particularly know the exactly what that would be, but I would guess that they have to have a significant capital expansion project, which required a related list of plans. That's the only thing I know.
Well, I guess you have to have the plan, so that brings the applicant all the way down a little also, especially on the surveys. Yeah. I'm sorry, go ahead.
That's a good observation, honestly. On sewer, the rates range from $9.38 a thousand. Minimum is the Beaufort rate, 57 cents a thousand gallons, which we can turn into a debt, it's a subject on something. You can see the Cumming is at $2.80 per thousand, where the Forsyth County rate is just about covered at $4.80 per thousand gallons, and that's 5.89. So, what's the money that the city needs to update their rate on sewer that they would charge the county? If you can do the best for the exhibit, sure. That's it. We took each of these separately, water sewer and water water. First thing we looked at was a water charge. And the cost of treat and what brings the water to the city of Cumming is $2.98 per thousand gallons. And you're charging the county presently $2.43. So you're 55 cents under your cost in what you're now charging.
So that means the city's been subsidized to the county over the years.
That's right. You've been charging less than the cost that it takes to produce it. There is money, so to say. The city is 55 cents per thousand gallons. We're suggesting and recommending that you change that rate to $5 per thousand gallons. They pay that rate whenever they want. The total water that the county can produce enough of it. As I understand, they would not be able to perform prior purchases, so the president would be. So the jumping up from $2.43 to $5 a thousand gallons. Again, the average water rate is in the communities. It's $5.39. This proposed rate was going to be less than that which you explained.
And looking at your 19, again, question for this, looking at your 19 cities that you got information from and their rates here in the study, I was noticing that the city of Cumming rate is the cheapest of any of
them. $2.40.
And this is the cheapest of any of us. So, your recommendation is that we charge about $10.5 a thousand.
The rate from the city to the county to the county would be $5 a thousand. And that would be the order. My other purchase when the power lands and the county came to pump the water from their plant to capture the distribution system. So, it's really coming out of the county. Being able to build outside of the sewer and
two of them again with, for all of our customers, not just the county. But also the county's rate would make it too low. Their county rates compared to the cities is, we charge the county $243 right now. And under the old contract, we still use the old contract. The city's rate is $243. And the county charge is $485. So across the board, the city and the county rates appear to be, according to your study, too low.
That's what we're going now.
The sewers, I get Councilmember questions on the one. Going to go ahead and explain.
Well, we're going to the sewers. Like the requirement of middle range, the cost of trip was there is $5.48. We got that by taking all the funds, the cost of operating the first work plant, power, labor, chemicals, testing, all that. And then we sold $1 million over the year. We divided that by minus wastewater in the street and came up with a cost of $5.48. Right now, the charge for the county is $3.04. So that's another one that's a, we might even get the cost of that. So, something there is $2.44 per thousand gallons. That's been going on for a long time. And in addition to that, several months back, we were asked to look at the connections to the city sewer that in the county area. And we found a number of connections. But in the county, I looked onto the city sewer, one being in charge. Build a city center county. And I think working with the city staff, we made there's great progress on that. Probably had 156 customers, I don't know exactly number, I don't remember. But there were a number of users that were getting off around the city being paid. So that's been great. So,
let me be sure I understand. During your study, you found out that there's 50 or 60 customers that the county's water, wastewater department has hooked on to the sewer system without dealing with
their house or business was within the city. It was in the county limits. However, the city sewer had been extended to them, serving them, and wasn't being picked up by the county.
I know when y'all were working on the study, your employees, they worked with the county department on some of this to find out some of this property, and also worked with other utilities to work on this. So,
I thought the county was very receptive and responsive in looking at the place. Where it wasn't right, it is right now.
So, well, the problem is what happened over the years, the city had sold the county certain amount of allocation, sewer allocation. And they had used that sewer without billing, letting the city know the billing part of it. So we weren't able to bill the county for that portion. Is that what it appeared to be?
I guess.
Just slipped through the cracks, 50 or 60 customers, and were these commercial or residential or?
Well, it was a mixture of both.
Okay. Well, hopefully we can get that correct and where the city can start taking that revenue.
Looking at the sewer situation, the rate to the county needs to go up to $6 a thousand gallons. Which just marginally gets you over your average cost of food.
The city's currently charging the county $3.04.
$3.04. It's costing $5.48. And we're saying $36.
cover the sewer, and then you want to go for raw water?
Yes, sir.
Can you explain that?
I will. Cumming has a water plant, they can only put drinking water out of water that's been drawn from Lake Honea. And water has to be pumped and transported to the county plant through the city of Cumming's intake. It was completed a couple of years ago. Also, maybe 17 or 18 million miles. Rates that we've been looking at, really, we've got four different rates. Depending on whether or not they pay you back, we're pretty much sure of 17 or 18 million miles spent. And the stock ratio has been estimated, I think everyone, Uber agrees, the ratio of the intake being 65%, where ultimately 34% of the city is going to be projected to use 35%. So, if some rates include the city, the county, 11.4 million, that's where they're on, where they're at. And looking at the cost of the charge, we look at the replacement cost to build, and we can either use the cost going into the rate of $18 million, which is the cost, or we can use the rate to the county, the rate at which they would rate to spend, their planning spend, which is $50 million. So those rates are factored into rates 2 to 4. And you can see that the revenue over what it pays, the rates vary from 20 cents per thousand gallons to 48 cents per thousand gallons. So we think at this point, probably the rate needs to rise to 48 cents. It doesn't. So far, the county hasn't stepped up and offered to pay their roadblock share of the expensive impact that the community has. So I would say that sort of runways are ready to move forward. And I would say we have it. Charging a fair rate to the county is something in the order of 30 to 48 cents per pound of gas.
Okay. And that is under, I believe you got your rate numbers under 1 through 4 on the raw water, and your first one is if the city recovers. $1.4 million in capital improvement cost, which is 65% of the $17 million that was spent on the Lake Lanier intake. You are proposing that the city charge, in addition to that, is 20 cents a thousand gallon for raw water.
That's what that's just about the cost to operate it, the power, the labor charge for the engineers. Land repairs. It does not include land repairs. If you've got a big motor that goes out $200,000 or $300,000, then whatever agreement you have with the county, they should pay 65% of those major replacements. Those are not, it's impossible to know that they are, and they're not included. So the 20 cents is just good.
And according to your annual revenue, that 20 cents a thousand gallon on raw water takes in $1 million
a year. About half of it goes to operating. 20 cents is operating costs and personnel and highway tourism.
Okay.
Council, have any questions? In a nutshell, Mayor, it looks like that you, in the treated water, you recommend that the city of Cumming go from $2.43 a thousand gallons to $5 a thousand. What's the recommendation?
On the rate.
On the city.
On the rate.
On the rate that the city's recommending.
It's not making a recommendation for all the customers. That's another discussion. Whether the charge of time is due.
Okay. And on the sewer, right now the city charges county $3.04, and you're recommending go to $6.
And that's based on what we believe that the county believes.
And also, on the capital recovery cost of $11.4 million, is your recommendation if we go to number one, that they pay the city $11.4 million, which is 65%, and you recommended 26 thousand gallons of raw water, that you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Council, have any questions, Rupert?
Thank you, Rupert.
Thank you for that.
Thanks for allowing us to work.
Just a few comments. This information that was presented here was, is not something we're going to act on currently. We needed information for the records, and we needed some kind of on record and in the books that we know what the city's cost of producing the product for water and raw water. Basically, that's what we're talking about with the county. I think the city has provided bottled water and the raw water at a very, very fair price over the years. Even though it's been too cheap, I think we've been negotiating this. The city has made a proposal to sell the county water for $2.25 a thousand gallon for a 5-year, with a 5-year option. We have consummated that. We've also made a proposal to sell the raw water based on the fact that they would pay the sale $11.4 million as was required in the contract that expired May 26th. We have consummated the deal on that. We're still working on it. Just today, the city received this afternoon a proposal from the county that we haven't had a chance to look at and go through item by item. And as I told the newspaper when they called me that last time, I hadn't seen the copy from the county. So I received it this afternoon. And the board was made privileged to it tonight when they came to the meeting. So we haven't had a chance to go over it. We will go over it and make a response back to the county. And in the meantime, in the interim time, we are operating under the old contract that expired May 26th. As I said, this information that was presented, we needed this for air records so we could have some kind of guideline. But we're not going to act on this. We're going to try to work out things with the county. So I'm glad to recognize three of the commissioners here tonight. We have Commissioner Tam, Commissioner Amos, and Commissioner Bale. We also have Commissioner Bobby who came in over here. So I'm glad they were here so they could hear firsthand. We diligently tried to work with the county over the last 12, 14 months on the water, regardless of what you might see on your website. I was taught as a kid, sometimes you don't believe everything you see, and most of the time you don't believe everything you hear. So this is the case with this water. You hear a lot of things about it, and most of it's not true. So the only thing will be true is whenever we come up with a final document that's signed by the city and county, and I have verbally agreed with the county on some things, so we haven't got it right yet. So hopefully we can get this done in the next few days, and we'll be able to sign off on it with the county. So that's the water in a nutshell. My comments to the council, have any comments? If not, I think that concludes the agenda. Anything else to be added? Council, have any? I have a motion to adjourn. Have a second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Be out. Thank you very much. Thank all of you.
Gerald, you got any speaking?